Good morning. Today we have to start a variable which may contain more than one things. Yet we have learned a lot that the variables are the facility in which the data are stored, by which the code which we generate for our purpose, they implement their processing. But whenever it is required that a variable more than one values should be considered as single name. For that very purpose, we have a facility in C programming language, and that is array. The characteristics of array, it means it may contain multiple values but of same data type. But of same data type, it means all the values should be of uniform mode. I mean, if the values are integer, then all should be integer. If they are in real, I will keep decimal. The value which contains decimal, that those are considered as real values. Like this, 3.25, 7.35, these are the real values. So, in C programming language, we have a facility of array in which we may store multiple values but of same data type, that is array. Now the question arises, how we will use the array in our programs? For that very purpose, as we know that all the variables which have to be used in the program, that should be declared first. So the array should be declared in a program like this manner. If the values are of integer type, then we declare it as int variable name, I mean array name, arint with a a square bracket. That square bracket, the number of elements which are considered, which may contain in that particular array. Like here, if we have to store 5, values, then we will write here 5. This is the way by which we declare the array in our programs. Now, the next question, how these values will be stored in that particular array? For that very purpose, we use loops. Whatever the loop, you may use any of these which is suited for the purpose. Generally, we use the for loop. For loop is a loop in which we know in beginning that how many times the loop has to be executed. As it is determined that the 5 elements has to be stored in the array, so loop will be executed 5 times. So we use the loops to store a variable. Likewise, to read the value from the array, the loop is also used. Whenever the value will be required, we use respective loops and we get ready-made data from that array for our purpose. This is the array declaration and execution.
Array. Let's take an example to illustrate the use of array. So, example of array has include stdio.h has include we are considering a two-dimensional array. So int I j, these are the variables to execute the loop, and the array is named as mat. And since it is two-dimensional, that's why two square brackets are required. First square bracket represents the row number of rows, and the second one represents the number of columns. CLRSCR, clear screen, and print, putting a label to show that what the user have to do. It is an instruction for user इंटर सिक्स वैल्यूज फॉर ए टू डायमेंशनल एरे। नाउ पुट लूप फॉर I is equal to 0, I less than 2i plus plus, and for column 4 j is equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus. scanf %d ampersand mat I j. So these are for the input of the array. Up now we have to see how they are appearing on the screen. Again print put a label printf \ and entered two dimensional array is. For I is equal to 0, equal to 0, I less than 2, I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus. Printf (3D, comma, mat I j). For line change printf So this is the program. Okay, let's save it. Save ar1.c. Now compile and execute. Enter six values. Enter 10, 20, 30, 50, 60, and 70. So this is the appearance. We have entered six values and they are appearing here in two rows and three columns. Since we have put here instruction to give them two rows, I is equal to 2, 3 columns, j is equal to 3. So this is the way by which the arrays are declared. simply putting the name and the number of elements containing a square bracket containing the number of elements. If it is a two-dimensional, two square brackets are required. If it will be one-dimensional, one are required. Now I am converting this into one-dimensional. Just 6 enter 6 values for a for an array. Here it will be 6 and this does not require. This 2 is not required. Entered one dimensional array is here, it will be 6 and this we don't require. If the output is in same line, then it is not required. So this is also not required. So the same program will give us a one dimensional array. Control F. 40, 50, 60, 90, 80, 70. In same way it will appear. In same way it is appear. Now the array which should be appeared in row wise. It means one column in one row, I mean key one value in one row. So we will give a command to change the line after each entry. So this block is required. Now we will see how this will work. Control F9. Again 10, 20, 30, 90, 80. 70 and this appears 10 20 30 90 80 70 line wise. So this is the way by which we declare a array, use the array for accessing values, I mean to writing the value in the array and taking away the values from the array. So one more thing we should know, since array is a variable, so it should have the capability to become the argument of a function. So if necessitates, situation necessitates, we may use the array as argument of a function. I am taking an example by which it will be clearly understood to you. Okay, int, I am giving an array whose name is ARR. And that is initialized as well as in that is defined as well as initialized with 10 values. Here I am defining a as defining a num 10. Num is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. This is the array. This is a program to identify the largest element of the array. INT X, INT Max, INT INT temp array, INT size, printf n largest of the array teach percent d. Max A double R num. Now I am writing the function int max. Our function name is max. For 10 max if temp AR I greater than temp max, temp max is equal to temp A double R I. Return temp max. So this is the program in two functions, one main function that contains the declaration initialization of the array and the max function which compare the array elements and give the maximum one. So we are moving to compile and execute the program. So largest of the array element is 44. Let's check Yes, 10, 12, yes, in the array, the 44 is the largest. We may change it. This 12, I made this 12 to 92. Now, let's see what happens. Control F. Yes, 92. This is the result. Again, if you wish, you may change 100. Control F9. Yes, 100 is the result. So, here we see how an array becomes the argument of a function. So, this is the all about the array.